On a dit biodiversité.
Fraction vivante de la nature. Biodiversity, living fraction of nature.
C'est surtout pas uniquement un catalogue d'espèces, ce n'est pas ça.
We don't want to make a catalogue of species. It's not a list.
En fait, c'est tout l'ensemble des relations que les êtres vivants ont.
It's about the relationships of living beings between themselves and with the environment. This is biodiversity. And the question being asked today is, we know that biodiversity is in danger, and we ask ourselves whether there are limits to human activity on the planet. So many general papers have been published in reviews. This is Nature 2009. People look at environmental matters, climatic changes, acidification of the oceans, phosphorus, nitrogen, the hole in the ozone layer, the use of drinking water, pollution of sea and land, and biodiversity is one of the main elements, and it disappears very quickly, much too quickly. And you have a picture here of African refugees following the Tunisian events in the Mediterranean. 7 billion human beings, and the human beings are directly linked with the changes, and partly they are responsible for those changes permanently. A lot of work is being conducted on Fall of the Wild, disappearance of the wild in science. The paper was published 3 years ago. Everywhere, in oceans and in sweet water, species disappear on the continent in water. The reference here is 1970, a document published last year. The WWF tells us that in 44 years we have lost not half of individuals in populations on the 1,000 populations that are permanently present. The speed is increasing, 7 billion humans. We represent 90% of the mammal biomass on Earth. Which species are disappearing? A document was drawn up in 2005. Heads of governments gathered in Reykjavik wanted to review the state of the planet. Economic Millennium Assessment. 1,400 researchers across the world participated in drawing up this document. First of all, they updated an old notion called the notion of services rendered by the ecosystem. What can man derive from this function? If we lose a function, what service do we lose? And at the time, people said that species disappear at 1,000 times faster than over the last 500 million years. Now, the figure was changed. We're talking about 300 times faster, but still 300 times faster. Here we have pictures of dwarf elephants in the Mediterranean, migrating pigeons in America, dodo in Mauritius, the Arctic penguin, and the Beiji, the Yangtze-Kiang dolphin, which officially became extinct in 2007. And people said, oh, who cares? We didn't know that dolphin. Yes, but the dolphin lived in a river where the water was so loaded that you can see your hand if you dipped it in water. And yet, it had invented the most fabulous echolocation system ever invented by a living being, a beautiful model of biomimetism, and that dolphin disappeared. It became extinct. Here we have pictures from the prehistoric caves, Lascaux, Altamira. The species drawn here have disappeared. So people started raising a question, debated in a paper published in 2011 in Nature. Are we creating the conditions for extinction crisis number 6? There were 60 in 500 million years, five major. Most important one, 2.5 million years ago, and ecosystems are polluted, they disappear, they are stocks are overexploited, there is overfishing in the ocean and the tropical forest on continents. One quarter of France's area disappears in the tropical forest every year. We have eradicated between 50 and 70% of all pelagic fish species in the seas, and there is anarchical dissemination. Here we have a little flagellate cell, a very nice little cell called Alexandrium, but if it can release a toxin that will kill a human being in 20 minutes, and it travels across the world in the tankers, because they empty 400, they empty 200,000 tons of water to load the oil. And recently, I said to a man, look out the window, there are 16 tankers that are discharging European water in Oman's water to load oil. So don't worry, don't. No wonder you have problems. This microjelly was introduced in the Black Sea in 1980. 1 million tons of biomass a few years later, ruining 40,000 tons worth of fishing. And the climate is going awry, and the sea level is increasing. And these four reasons explain the difficulties undergone by biodiversity. So this ecological crisis has been called climatic deregulation more than change, agricultural productivism, the lack of drinking water, overfishing, fishes disappearing, deforestation, which makes progress, biodiversity is collapsing, and toxic products are present even in areas where there are no human beings. So NGOs are fighting, trying to save the species, which are symbolic, emblematic, they remarkable. I don't want to talk about remarkable species. Nature did not invent remarkable species. Yes, some of them can be noticed, but they are not remarkable. Here we have a species on the bottom right-hand side, people on the Catalan beach, Belgians, Parisians, Germans, they all come and have a bath at 6 o'clock in the afternoon. They have saved money for 6 months and they all swim happily in water loaded with the fecal streptococci. So UICN says 800 species have disappeared across the continent. Of which 18 in the ocean. But it means that we have ruined the population and the stores of species. And this is only true for a few species that were remarked, that were noticed. And we don't see all of the biodiversity in danger here. Madagascar, 8,000 years ago, 94% of forests. In 1950, 50% of forests. Today, 12% of forests. We're fighting to preserve the last lemurs. Here we have Borneo forest at the top, 24 tigers in the reserve, and the large orangutans. And at the bottom, we have oil palms and billions of hectares of forests have disappeared in a few years. Here we have INRA data showing that trees in eastern France follow the model and they go up in altitude, but they can't keep up with the pace on the plains. It changes. Nature is used to change, but things are changing too fast for nature to keep up now.